Okay, I know I can't be the only one who heard Hallelujah was the music for this trailer and thought about the sex scene between Night Owl and Silk Spectre and the Watchmen. Am I right? Come on, you know you did. No, just me. Okay. Well, my mind's in the gutter. Nothing new there. Hallelujah! This trailer has dropped. Okay, I know I'm not exactly being original there by shouting hallelujah, because everybody and their mother who has reacted and reviewed to this trailer has probably shouted hallelujah. So, you know what? Go ahead and add my name to this list. And you know what? When I heard Hallelujah was the music for this trailer, I instantly thought of Watchmen. But it's not the music I thought I was going to hear. And honestly, I thought we were going to hear the original music that we heard for the first trailer for the Justice League by Junkie XL. But I heard Hallelujah, and I was just like, I don't think this is going to work for this trailer. But as I watched the trailer and as it went on, I was like, you know what? No, this is definitely fitting. And you know, hallelujah, I thought of Watchmen, but maybe it's more like hallelujah for the Snyder Cut fans who have been asking for this movie for years now, and they finally have it, and everybody is shouting hallelujah. At least that's kind of what it felt like to me, anyway. But yeah, this trailer, if you need any more evidence that the Snyder Cut is going to be vastly different than the theatrical cut, look no further than this trailer, because that's exactly what this trailer is supposed to tell you, is that, hey, the Snyder Cut is going to be very different from the theatrical cut, or the Justice League, as the internet has branded it. And if you want to talk about different, let's talk about the Flash in this trailer. Because in the Justice League, the Flash was, you know, the comic relief. And, you know, the comic relief and cracking jokes is more of an attribute that I give to Wally West. Because, you know, I'm a fan of the Justice League animated series. And so when I hear Wally West, I think of, you know, a wisecracking Flash. And I know Wally isn't always, you know, cracking jokes. He can be serious when he needs to be. But it's just, you know, the wise ass attribute I, you know, give to Wally West. You know, Barry Allen, he's more of a serious character. You know, he's kind of a brood in the comics. And so seeing him as the comic relief, it didn't really work for me in the theatrical cut. But, you know, Flash in this trailer, he's definitely serious. Because at the end of the trailer, he's like, look, this guy has probably fought thousands upon thousands of superpowered beings on all the planets that he's conquered. And you know he's won. So what chance do we stand against him? And the reason for that, for, you know, Barry being scared and be very serious that they could lose this fight is that we see him, you know, tap into the speed force for, you know, the first time. And he probably time travels to that nightmare world, you know, that hellscape that we first saw in BVS. And, you know, there's a few Easter eggs, you know, strewn in this scene. We can see Aquaman's trident. We see, you know, the Justice League, you know, little, tablet right there. You can make out Wonder Woman's broken shield, and you can see the Joker card, you know, floating through the air. And so my guess is that Barry, using the Speed Force, travels to this nightmare world. And he's scared shitless. It scares the crap out of him. Because he sees that Steppenwolf and Darkseid have won. And you have an evil Superman and a grim knight Batman. And when he comes back, you know, he may or may not tell the other members what he saw during his time travel experience. My guess is that he probably won't, but he'll be like, look, we don't stand a chance against this guy. You know, we could very well lose this fight. And I really appreciate seeing Barry, you know, react this way instead of cracking jokes, being like, hey, we might lose this fight right here. Now, we also see him save Iris in this trailer, which was something that was teased for Justice League when it was, you know, coming out originally by Zack Snyder. And we didn't get that in the Justice League. It was cut. And, you know, there's those certain couples that just belong together. Superman and Lois Lane, Barbara Gordon and Dick Grayson, and Barry Allen and Iris. Those are just the way it's supposed to go. And seeing, you know, their first meeting, it puts a smile on my face. We also get to see more of Cyborg. And Zack Snyder always stated that Cyborg was going to be the heart of the movie. And the Justice League, he really wasn't the heart of the movie. You know, he was just kind of like another character in the movie. But this trailer, we see a lot of Cyborg. We first see him, you know, during the football game, because Cyborg was an athlete before he was Cyborg. And so we see him, you know, playing football, which was, you know, another thing that was cut from the theatrical cut. We also see him digging up a grave. At least I think he's digging up a grave here. It's probably Superman's grave, because that's one thing that never really made any sense to me in the Justice League, was you had the Flash and Cyborg digging up Superman's grave. And I'm just like, why are we wasting time here, movie? The Flash can dig up this grave in like 2 seconds flat. Why are we having this moment here? Let's, come on, the time is of the essence. But, you know, Barry, he might be time traveling, like I said, you know, using the Speed Force to travel to that nightmare world. And so it's just Cyborg, you know, digging up the grave. Or, you know, maybe he's punching the grave. You know, it could be the grave of his father. Because we do see him in this trailer, and he looks messed up. You know, he looks possessed by either the Mother Box or Steppenwolf. And, you know, probably to open up the Mother Box. And he still has enough wherewithal to be like, if I open up this Mother Box, it will cause untold destruction. So I'm going to sacrifice myself so the box doesn't open. And, you know, we see him, you know, kind of like Dr. Manhattan, just kind of, you know, just explode here. And, you know, Cyborg is yelling at him, no. And it's this really just gut-punching emotional moment for Cyborg. We also see him, you know, struggling to control his own body. And Aquaman even mentioned in, you know, the Justice League, how can we trust this guy? Because he was created by the Mother Box. He might be a double agent. And it's just kind of brushed off as, no, I'm not a double agent. I'm a good guy. But here we see him struggling to walk, you know, struggle to control his own body. And I would really love it to see in this movie that internal struggle for Cyborg, you know, to regain control of his own body from the Mother Box, you know. It's just, like I said, it's something that's just brushed off in the Justice League. But here you can definitely see, you know, he has that coding in his mind, you know, that language he doesn't speak. And so, you know, there's going to be that struggle between, you know, the Mother Box that wants, you know, to turn on his allies. But Cyborg is like, no, when you see that conflict, I really want to see that for a Cyborg. And we also get some, you know, shots here of the villains. And we actually see Darkseid. And Darkseid, he looks... I guess he looks okay. You know, I mean, I'm not really blown away by this design for Darkseid. You know, here he just kind of looks like a big gray man with the Omega symbol on his chest. But you know what? Maybe this is more like past Darkseid, because it was always said that, you know, I think Kevin Smith mentioned it, that the ending to the Justice League was the boom tube opens up and you see Darkseid. So maybe at the ending of the movie, you know, when the boom tube opens up, we see Darkseid and he's wearing his like apocalypse armor. And, you know, he takes the body of Steppenwolf and just leaves. And, you know, the Justice League is just like, oh, we won, but there's a bigger threat out there. You know, Darkseid is coming. So maybe that is. But, you know, as this design right here, I'm not really digging it. You know, like I said, he just kind of looks like a big gray man, you know, with, you know, the Omega symbol on him. But how about Dessaud? That was a shock to me because I didn't even know Dessaud was supposed to be in the Justice League. And I saw him and I was like, oh, fuck. Dessaud's gonna be in this movie. And the role he's going to play, I don't really know. You know, maybe he's going to be like a lieutenant to Steppenwolf. You know, I really can't say at this moment. But let's talk about Steppenwolf. And just, oh my god, that is so much better. Because Steppenwolf in the Justice League is just... he just looks like a PlayStation 2 boss. You know, that you would see. He just looked goofy as hell. But this version of Steppenwolf is badass. He looks so much better here. From here, we get a few, you know, other interesting shots. We also see that, you know, Bruce does, in fact, have a hologram image of Superman. You know, it was always kind of speculated that he had this hologram of Superman that he kind of, like, stares at. But it was never really confirmed. But, you know, in this trailer, it's definitely like, yeah, he has this hologram of Superman. And that's really, you know, par for the course for Batman. Because, you know, he, you know, puts on, like, displays of, like, his fallen soldiers in his cave. You know, he has the display of Jason Todd, and, you know, now he has, you know, this hologram to remind himself how he failed, you know, Superman, and how he has to be better, a better hero for this league to stop, you know, the impending doom that's coming. We also get a few scene here with Martha Kent and Lois Lane as they hug. We also get to see Superman in the black suit. You know, that's straight from The Death of Superman. You know, the black suit with the silver S. And sadly, no mullet. No super mullet. I mean, just picture this. You know, Superman is resurrected in this movie. And he's just wearing a bitchin' mullet. And just, I personally would love to see it. I don't think we're really gonna see, you know, super mullet. But it would just... it would put a smile on my face if I just saw Superman is resurrected and he's just got this bitchin' mullet, you know, just, you know, floating in the air, you know, shirtless. He's got this bitchin' mullet. Like, come on. You know you want to see it. But I honestly don't think we're going to see it. We have a scene of Clark, you know, hugging Martha and Lois in a cornfield. Also, we have this shot of, like, Batman blocking, like, laser fire with his gauntlets. And my friend was just like, how is his gauntlets blocking laser fire? That makes no sense. And, you know, I mentioned, well, if parademons have been coming to Earth, especially Gotham, to sort of scout out the land, Batman would have probably, you know, found one or two. Kind of like in the New 52 Justice League comics, where he finds one. So to me, it makes sense that, you know, maybe he found one of them and saw that they shoot like laser blasts. And, you know, he upgraded his suit because he was like, okay, these things are a lot more dangerous. I need to upgrade the suit to be ready for these things. So to me, it just makes sense that he would upgrade the bat suit and as well as the gauntlets, you know, to protect himself from laser fire. Because we saw that in the Telltale Batman, you know, where he would put up his gauntlet above his mouth to protect himself from getting shot in the mouth. So, you know, I just, you know, think that he's upgraded his suit because he's ran into a few parademons. And then by far the best line in the entire trailer goes to Batman at the end of the trailer, where he's like, I don't care how many demons he's fought and how many hells, he's never fought us. Us united. And then boom, you have the shot. And it's like that right there is the Justice League. Oh, also, there was this like moment in the trailer. It's like a blink and you miss it part, but there's this moment where like you see a bunch of like missiles coming towards it's like Cyborg, and he like Jedi mind trick waves his hand and they all like flow away. So I'm wondering, is that like real? Like, is he like has he using his technology tapped into these missiles just to avert them somewhere else? I don't really know what's going on in the scene. If you guys have any ideas, please let me know in the comments below, because I've watched that scene so many times because I watched this trailer, you know, before this video to sort of collect my thoughts and kind of what I want to talk about. And it's funny because I watched it once and then I watched it again. And then I watched it again, and I watched it again, and it gives me chills, you know? It just puts a smile on my face, you know? It's a good trailer, and I'm definitely looking forward to this. And you can definitely expect a full review of the Snyder Cut when it drops in 2021. I've heard this is going to be put together in 4-hour-long parts, as well as a complete 4-hour cut of the movie. I've also heard it's going to be released internationally, so people that don't have HBO Max can experience the Snyder Cut, which is really the only cut of the Justice League that matters at this point. So I would definitely love to have the DVD of it, you know. Just I would buy the most expensive version of that just to have it, because yes, so much yes. All right, folks, so that is all the time I have for this video. Down in the comments below, as always, please let me know what you thought of the trailer. Did you like it? Did for some reason, you know, you didn't like it? You know, tell me why. What was your favorite part of the trailer? I really like discussions and getting things, you know, discussing things with other fans because everybody's different. And everybody has, you know, something different to say about the trailer. So I love talking to people and, you know, creating discussions about stuff. So by all means, you know, talk about it in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and poke that bell icon to stay updated on all my videos. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see y'all at the next episode. You guys have yourself a fantastic day.